everything we've been led to believe is a lie. When we get chosen by the gods, they're choosing us for death, murder, automatic expiration. The great beyond is bullshit.
It's crazy talk.
I know you don't want to believe it, but I have proof.
Hey, I just wanted to talk about a point someone brought up in the chat, actually, which is I'm glad they did it, because I hear this a lot, and specifically when you talk about pop culture of movies and music, people go, oh, that's satanic, that's, you know, like people go, oh, fuck, that was done by Stanley Kubrick, that's a satanic movie, I'm not watching that. And it's like, you're never going to watch another movie again, and you're never going to listen to another fucking song again if you have that. But this is how it works, right? And how you got to understand Satanism, because Satanism always offers free will. They have to operate within free will.
You set me up. You played me! It was a test! Your test!
But I'm no puppeteer, Kevin. I don't make things happen. Doesn't work like that. Free will. It's like butterfly wings. Once touched, they never get off the ground. I only set the stage. You pull your own string. God? Is that it? God? Well, I tell you, let me give you a little inside information about God.
What do you want?
I want a family.
I want a child. The Antichrist.
And this is why I see the U.S. Constitution and the Bill of Rights. That was set up as offering free will. They gave the world one country. There was a constitutional republic that had aspects of natural law written on paper, and said, if you fuck this up, we take it all, right? And that's why I think there's the prize for America. Now, they do this in music, and they do this in movies. Because people always say, you know, The Wizard of Oz is a mind control movie. It's like, even Diana, when she used to go around to the royal families when she was a child, before they were setting her up with Charles to be a prearranged marriage, she used to watch Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. And that was another mind control movie. But they're layered. It's same as like The Lord of the Rings. Same as J.R. Tolkien, right? Which is, you know, that is the story of the hijack of humanity. But that's on the satanic level. They can't manipulate you unless they put core truths. And within every movie is a hero's journey. And within every movie, it's the story of awakening. And at the start of it is, you know, the beginning of going on the quest. And it's basically the quest to find oneself. It's in every movie. And it's in most music as well. Now, if they just put out straight up satanic movies without that core spiritual message, it wouldn't work. It doesn't hit the psyche. And that's why I believe the Bible's been manipulated. And the greatest example of the hero's journey is the Jesus story. And it's because that story resonates with us, because it is the story of us. And at the beginning of the hero goes on the quest, you know, and it depends on where you pick up that point.
But man, you look a little whiter than usual. My computer, you ever have that feeling where you're not sure if you're awake or still dreaming?
All the time. It's called mescaline. It's the only way to fly. Look, it just sounds to me like, you know, you need to unplug, man. Man, get some R&R. Hey, what do you think, Deshaur? Should we take him with us?
Definitely.
I can't. I have work tomorrow.
Come on. It'll be fun. I promise.
Yeah. Sure.
As a collective, humanity went on a quest. We decided to come down here in human incarnation as a collective to go through this experience, both individually and collectively, to go on the hero's journey, which means at the end we win. It's not up for debate whether we win, and it's not even about winning. It's just at the end, you go through the whole cycle to what? To find out who you are. And a good example of the, like with the Beatles, right? You can listen to all Mike Williams stuff, and he's got a very, very in-depth knowledge of the Beatles story and the Paul McCartney story, right? And the duping and why they do that, why they had to offer you, you know, why they had to replace him, why they had to offer you this group, why they started out as pure and then they had to invert them.
And toward the end of the 60s, is that when the rumors about you being dead surfaced? Do you remember that? Do you remember, yeah. Remember how that started? What were your feelings about that?
Yeah, no, what happened was we did a cover for a record called Abbey Road. The idea was to walk across the crossing, and I showed up that day with sandals, flip-flops, and so it was so hot, and I kicked them off and walked across barefooted. So this started some rumor that because he was barefooted, he's dead. But it was a little bit strange because people did start looking at me like, is it him or a very good double?
Well, that was the idea. That was the other part of it, that there was a guy who looked like you taking your place.
No, well, this is him.
That's all part of, you know, that's part of what they did with the Good Girl Gone Bad, Rihanna, Britney Spears, Miley Cyrus. That's, they have to do that to you because they have to give you the purity, and they do it within every movie and every song. And with the Beatles, like, this is how much this one resonated. It got voted Song of the Century, and it was John Lennon's Imagine, which is an amazing song, right? And regardless of who wrote it, because if you listen to Mike Williams' stuff too, he'll say that Lennon and McCartney both received a lot of their music, their lyrics and inspiration within Dreams. Now, were they being manipulated or not? Obviously, there's a Tavistock connection. The Beatles were a product of Tavistock and MI5. But with the song Imagine, it's a beautiful song. He's talking about peace on earth, right? But then,
imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one.
Right? But then there's a satanic overtone, because peace on earth is that this is Satan's playground, and that he's basically, Imagine is really a story about communism, right? The one world, he's talking about one world.
And the world will be one.
Where everyone's united. Now you can pick that up both ways, because you know, he took no religion and no religion too. That's part of communism.
Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too.
Can look at that a good way. We shouldn't have a world of religion, because a religion is a structured belief system. There's only the truth, and that's it. And it's the same with, because I mentioned Sausage Party in there.
Everything we've been led to believe is a lie. When we get chosen by the gods, they're choosing us for death, murder, automatic expiration. The great beyond is bullshit.
Well, the person goes, oh, it's fucking done by a Jew. And it's like, there's like a distortion, massive, massive distortion that I've seen, particularly with, as the awakening has happened, and particularly people that have started waking up since COVID happened, that's the beginning of the journey, right? You're in the unknown world, and then you become so imbalanced on one side, so distrusting, and paranoid about everything, that everything's satanic, that you then don't trust anything. And then you're more open then to be, because you've been so distorted onto the dark side, to then when they offer you the false light, you're going to hook it up, hook, line and sinker. And that's the plan of that. I see so many that, you know, like, just paranoid delusion that everything's satanic. And it kind of is and it isn't. And it's, like I said before, it's a universe of contrast. There's a yes and a no for almost every, everything. So, you know, there is beauty within movies written and performed by Satanists. There's beauty within music written and performed by Satanists, because they know if it doesn't have that core spiritual message in it, that they can't put their undertones in it, and then it's meaningless. It does nothing. So just people to, like, be more open-minded to see the good and the bad within everything. And that's the thing too, because everyone's a Satanist. Everyone's been a Satanist. Everyone's had periods of their time where they worship their own ego. They're not concerned about the collective. They're about me, my. That's the whole fucking collective society. That's Satanism. You don't have to be raping children and chopping up dead babies to be a Satanist. It's basically that you see yourself as, I'm going to get mine and fuck everyone else. And that's been the world for fucking a long, long time. So, you know, don't have a go at Satanists unless you're willing to look at yourself, because you have been a Satanist. We've all been Satanists. I just thought, I want to get that out there. There's so many examples of this, like, particularly, like, I posted about, if you go to my Instagram, Mark Passio, it's a very old presentation he'd done on The Wizard of Oz. He's done these breakdowns of a lot of these movies. And the good thing about Mark Passio is he has a very, very good understanding of what Satanism is. And I learned the simplicity of what Satanism is by going, looking a lot at Mark Passio's work after I was imbalanced on the distorted side, when I was, years ago, was just consuming information on satanic rituals and satanic cults, which is, you know, one of the, that's the, you know, the furthest dark expression of that. But Mark Passio really brings it back to the simplicity of what Satanism is. So if you go watch that one, it's really good. He breaks down The Wizard of Oz and the archetypes that are in each of these movies. And these people that have written these books and these movie scripts, they are the priestly caste, man. They are wizards. They are fucking experts in the occult. And the dark occult understand the light. You know, that's the difference about them, right? Whereas, you know, particularly a lot of Christians, they don't want to look at the dark because it's satanic. You don't look at it. Whereas the advantage the Satanists have on us is they look at the dark and the light. They understand both aspects. And that's why and then they make a conscious choice to go to the dark. And then that's why when they can write these movies, they have the core message of truth, understanding and finding oneself, going on the journey, awakening. And then they put their satanic layering in there, you know, like Follow the Yellow Brick Road, which is even in the spiral with, you know, when she starts on the Yellow Brick Road and it starts spinning out, that's because when you see, you can't see where the journey's going. When you go from the unbegun, the unconscious, to start to see yourself as conscious, as Dorothy starts to go spin out of the spiral of the Yellow Brick Road and puts herself sets herself out to follow the synchronicities and intuition to bring her back to where she needs to be.
Now, the Yellow Brick Road represents the path to spiritual enlightenment, the path toward illumination and higher levels of consciousness. That's why it's gold. This is the alchemical gold that the alchemists seek to create. And it leads to the light, okay? We'll see what the Emerald City represents shortly.
Which is to find herself. But then following the Yellow Brick Road has a satanic a layering in it too. And this is why I think that the Satanists chose these stories like The Wizard of Oz to do programming in it, because when they're programming someone through MKUltra, they're actually using the core stuff within our DNA about, you know, the going on our path and our quest, and they're laying in satanic layering with it, and that's why it works. Even like in music, they use the symbolism of water. Right now, water is purification, but the Satanists use it, and they use the word rain or rain man to be Satan or the devil. And you're like, Madonna's got that song, you know, rain, feel it all. They do it all the time. Jay-Z calls himself Rain Man. Jay-Z calls himself Rain Man.
Tip to the rainy day. Jay, Rain Man is back.
And they did that song with Rihanna. And she's actually singing under my umbrella, Ella, and she goes, Ella, 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 eh, eh.
Have each other, you can stand under my umbrella, you can stand under my umbrella, Ella, Ella, eh, 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 under my umbrella, Ella, Ella, eh, 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 under my umbrella, Ella, Ella, eh, 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 under my umbrella, Ella, Ella, eh, eh, eh.
Allah, Al is the Old Testament word for God, because God in the Old Testament, Al, Elohim, which is gods, Al means Saturn. Al is the god of Saturn, and Saturn is Satan. So when Rihanna is singing Umbrella and she goes, Ella, Ella, this is satanic chant. She's chanting to the god of Saturn. There's so many songs about rain. Go listen to how many songs you can go find about rain, but that's what they do. They use the opposite of purification to then be bringing the rain of Lucifer down. And the reason rain is God is because God was the bearded man. That's why they say the father son. He comes from above and brings the rain, and the rain is supposed to be the male sperm that falls to the earth. The Old Testament, Al, Elohim, which is gods. Al means Saturn. Al is the god of Saturn, and Saturn is Satan. So when Rihanna is singing Umbrella and she goes, Ella, Ella, this is satanic chant. She's chanting to the god of Saturn. There's so many songs about rain. Go listen to how many songs you can go find about rain. But that's what they do. They use the opposite of purification to then be bringing the rain of Lucifer down. And the reason rain is God is because God was the bearded man. That's why they say the father son. He comes from above and brings the rain, and the rain is supposed to be the male sperm that falls to the earth, and then the earth is the mother, and that's how everything grows. It starts off with the reign of the man, right? So this is how they twist it. So, but then people that are just looking at the satanic side, they'll be going, oh, rain, anytime they mention rain, it's Lucifer. Well, it is on one level, but then it's not. And it depends what you pick up on each of these things. It's layering. So yeah, don't look at everything as just one thing. And Michael Jackson's songs are filled with satanic layering too, but especially a lot of Masonic stuff. Even like when he's doing beat it, watch his hand movement when he's going beat it. He's jacking off, right? That's what he. Doing, but then you know he's got songs like Heal the World and plenty of others, you know, they don't care about us, there's heaps of them. Well, actually one of the best Michael Jackson songs, never gets a mention, is Money. Go listen to the lyrics of Money. Great song.
Anything the money. But I say it's just in the devil's game of greed and lust. They don't care, they do me for the money. They don't care, they use me for the money. So you go to church, you read the holy word. In the scheme of life, it's all absurd. They don't care, they kill for the money. Do it there, they thrill for the money. You're saluting the flag, your country trusts you. Now you're wearing a badge, you're called the just few. And you're fighting the wars, that's all you must do. I'll never betray or deceive you, my friend, but
if you show me the cash, then I will take it. If you tell me to cry, then I will fake it. If you give me your hand, then I will shake it.
You will do anything for money. Anything, anything, anything for money. Die for you, I sell my soul to the devil.
Great song. Yeah, I think that's about all I wanted to say. But yeah, it's never only just one thing. It's a universe of contrast. You'll see what you want to see, but don't become too distorted to the satanic to think that everything's satanic. Even if it's written and made by Satanists, they still have to use the natural energies as well. Alright, bye.
I can see laughter, or I can see tears. I see a choice, love or fear. What do you choose? I can see peace, or I can see war. I can see sunshine, or I can see a storm. What do you choose? Now I choose to love with freedom flies. From my heart, where the light keeps shining. And I choose to feel the whole world crying for the strength that we can rise above. I choose love. I choose sharing, or I can see greed. I can see caring or poverty. So what do you choose? I can see gardens, or I can see bombs. I can see life or death coming on strong. What do you choose?
shining, and I choose to feel the whole world crying for the strength that we can rise above. I choose love. I choose darkness dying. I see us dawning as one world united. So what do you choose? Love or fear? Oh, we keep shining.